Hello. My name is Peter Finn. I am currently the Director of Learning and Development at the Society of Women Engineers. I graduated the MSLOC program in 2007. And Terry asked me to talk about nonprofits, and so nonprofit management. So one of the things that came to mind is working with volunteers, and specifically volunteer leadership, which is something that I've been doing for several years. So I want to first share a quote, though, that kind of speaks to why I work for nonprofits. And this is from a book by Peter Drucker. It's written over 20 years ago, but it's distinguishing a nonprofit from what a government does or what a for-profit does. The nonprofit institution neither supplies goods or services nor controls its product. Is neither a pair of shoes or an effective regulation. Its product is a changed human being. So for me, the product for a nonprofit is really a changed human being. It's changing a life forever. And that may translate to access to clean water, a literacy program, and that kind of explains why I do what I do. So how I got here, I taught high school right after I graduated from college for a couple years, and then I worked for a nonprofit based here in Chicago. It's called the Parliament of the World's Religions. And one of the, my job there was as a programs coordinator. And we were organizing a conference in Cape Town, South Africa. And it was an amazing, transformative experience and really kind of got me hooked for, you know, working for a mission-driven organization. And while we were there, we had Nelson Mandela as our keynote speaker, and one of the events that I organized, we had the Dalai Lama. It was just an amazing experience. But through that, I had to work with volunteers. And for better or worse, I learned that you cannot fire a volunteer. but they are also, they are a great source of passion. Money is always nice. Ideas and definitely leadership. And so working with volunteers, you know, I've worked for probably five or six different nonprofits, consulting, and then just, you know, currently what I'm doing. And you know, one of the toughest things is getting the leadership to really think strategically. So not kind of go in the weeds and confusing their role with your role as being staff. So it's, you know, it's a big source of frustration when you know, I'm on the a phone call with a board member and they're concerned about the color of a website, or they're worried about, you know, what we're going to be serving as a chicken entree at our next meeting. So I mean, those are the kinds of things that, you know, I've had to deal with, and so as a result, you know, kind of think constructively and proactively about what can we do with our board leadership. So, but one of the things that I had to kind of understand is what are the motivations of why people want to join a board or be on a board, and altruism, ego, and self-interest. And I want 80% of that decision to be based on altruism. I know that some ego will be involved there. You know, people are very flattered to be, you know, asked or recruited. And then there's obviously self-interest, where someone may raise their own profile or the profile of the organization. But I want to make sure that they're committed to the mission, and you know, which is very important for a nonprofit, and they want to give back to the community that you're serving and the constituency that you're serving. So, in addition to, you know, thinking about the motivations, also I've been thinking about, you know, some takeaways, and a big takeaway is setting up competencies for my board members. And I think that there are some critical questions to ask. You know, do they know the difference between managing and governing? So their job really is to govern, my job is to kind of manage and implement. One of the most critical things is, do they have a 3 to 5 year horizon for the organization? Can they think, so when we're doing all this strategic planning, can they think 5 years out? And that's a critical part. Can they work in teams? Can they inspire? Which, you know, philanthropic giving is huge. We need them to inspire other people to give to the organization. So all of these are big takeaways for me and things that I've been working on with boards. The other thing is boards, specifically in nonprofits, have just kind of swelled in size, you know, where you have 30 or 40 people on a board, and so you're taking all these remarkable, wonderful people and then putting them in a very inefficient process. So my recommendation to where I work and for other organizations is that the board really be 6 or 7 people, including the executive director, because I think that's the way that the most efficient decision-making will be made. And so I think with reducing the size of the board and setting up these competencies that that the organization can grow and be more strategic and focus on the future. So thanks.